Hello everyone. So today we are going to have a quick look on the presentation that I have brought over here as part of the DevNet Create, which is CXSDEM. So as the name goes by, it's a CX software delivery excellence model. It's a DevOps managed way to expedite the software delivery process. Before we go ahead with the presentation, let us get me into a brief overview or brief introduction about myself. So I am Sudipta, part of Software Architect DevOps Proactive Software. I work for Cisco Systems India Private Limited last 7 years, but in my this entire 20 plus years of experience of the expansion over here, I worked on delivery management, deployment of mobile telecom, satellite telecom, supply chain product, and many more. So my massive eagerness towards the DevOps expertization, because of that, I have come out with this paper to share with all of you, and I hope this would be a good session to take away from this particular paper. Let us understand what is the software delivery challenge today's world. Software delivery is a very complicated process as a whole, if we see that. It involves the architecting of the software, development, then coding, then testing, and then many more release certification process. And finally, the software gets delivered to the customer premise. So as we are moving out from the previous era of the software delivery process, where the process was mostly towards the waterfall model, we are now, everybody is following the agile process. So as part of this process, we are decomposing the monolithic approach of the software development into microservices-based approach. Now, microservices-based approach means we are breaking out the software into various modules. At some point of time when we have to deploy a function, the microservices-based approach, the integrations, its testing, its full-stack testing, the entire release certification is quite complicated in shape. On the other hand, the different technology stacks between different microservices has to be managed, which creates another level of complexity. Now, for the delivering all these things together, there could be a scenario that where someone is maintaining a development pipeline, someone is maintaining a testing pipeline, and then release pipeline. So controlling the multiple pipeline is also a challenge. So in this particular paper, we will see that how CXSDEM is a framework which targets to solve all these challenges together. Now, everybody is familiar about the DevOps and Agile delivery methodology, which is predominantly use case driven because we have to run the customer delivery to be aligned with our delivery, what customer actually wants. The basic problem statement comes over here when we get into the release to software provide to the customer, then it's user acceptance test, production install, and getting the things certified by the customer and meeting the target what customer actually wants. Now, let us understand how CXSDEM is going to solve this problem. We promise this framework can target to optimize your delivery process. Let's see how it is. So when we talk about continuous delivery and continuous automation, it's basically try to automate everything everywhere using a pipeline. Consider a scenario where build to test, test to deploy, and deploy to operations can be done in a seamless way. So that is where the ultimate customer experience comes into picture, where we can promise to give an 100% reliable software with reduction of time to market and giving a good quality of code to meet the expectation of the customer rather. So being said that, what is our challenges? Something changes in the code, we need to test. Something changes in the software package, we need to test. We need to build up the environment pipeline every time when we build and test. And finally, when something is being tested, instead of manual intervention, if it can be automatically checked and can be taken the release certification process as an automatic way, that is where the actual problem statement lies. So how as a delivery manager or how as a part of release manager, I should have a framework which can take this solution in a day-by-day incremental progress, so that we do not have to bother about what actually being delivered, is it up to the mark or not. So framework, if I can define a framework which can take care of all these things automatically fashion, then that would be the ultimate solution. Now, being said that, there is an underneath CI/CD stack is being used, which will help us to design this framework. So when we talk about the CI/CD stack, is basically part of continuous integration, which takes care of plan, build, test, QA, and continuous delivery, which basically takes care of publish, release, and deployment. In this whole scenario, there are certain industry standard tool sets are being used. Rally or Jira could be used for planning, tracking, and release management to be managed. GitHub can be used for the source control management. Jenkins teaches this entire thing as part of the continuous integration together. And in turn, to check the quality of the code, static code analysis tool SonarQube has been used. The test automation to certify the quality of the build, the automation test tool CXStar, which is in-house built up by Cisco, has been used. And finally, it is altogether being stitched with Cisco Secure Delivery Lifecycle, CSDL process, which ensures that the delivery is up to the mark with security protocol enabled. Nonetheless, the entire show is being executed also underneath one more tool, which is Artifactory, that uses the artifact management and repository to be targeted. So how the build will be getting delivered to the customer, that is being controlled by the Artifactory. Now, this particular pipeline is being designed in a multi-level way. So in our case, this is a basically use case taken from a customer place where we have a three product line, Network Service Orchestrator, NSO, Collaboration Workflow Manager, CWM, and the BPA is the Business Process Automation. So anything or everything we build up as part of our use cases, it involves these multiple products to be interacted. Now, when these multiple products to be interacted, we need a certain framework which should certify this product certification together. So what we have done, initially the build comes from the platform view. As you can see over here, the core platform delivers the build or delivers the code. On top of that, we, as part of the CX service delivery, we build up the service packages. Those packages are then being signed in, provided the Cisco Secure Network protocol to be followed. And finally, that gets together, all these things comes together, this three product line, and they get into deployed into the integration test bed. So as you can see over here, we have a dedicated lab where no code deployment happens, only the full stack deployment happens, and there the integration testing happens. Post integration testing, the release gets certified, and then it gets to deliver to the customer premise. Now let us understand how the things being executed over there. So here, if you see that the violet color box has been highlighted, we will see quickly that how exactly the things getting executed as part of this violet color box over there. So this is the example of development pipeline where the developer has built the code as part of release back version 7.5.xxx release. Here in the pipeline, as you can see, that first the things happen in the checkout of the code from the repository. Then you will be able to see going through the logs that what is the commit message. So the moment commit message is being tracked off, we could see that what branch the code has to be checked in and code building should start off. After that, the code gets into compile and getting into building the package. So how the compilation will happen? We have the platform-based packages, platform-based code, basically, not packages. On top of that, the service packages are being built up. Now, before doing this compile and build of the packages, we are setting the platform version. So here you could see that we have mentioned the platform version, and then if I click build, the pipeline will fetch that particular version of the CWM code from the platform, and it will start building up compilation and building up the packages on top of that. At this point of time, you could see that if I could open the logs, you could see that how the packages are being built up. One after another, the services will build up. And finally, here you see that the final package will come into the picture. These are all pre-services are getting built up using the platform code. And finally, this Epsilon-RPM, that packages is getting built up. Now, once this has been done, this is the time that the JUnit test should run through over there. So the pipeline is also integrated with the JUnit framework, which will run the unit test on the code. And if there is no failure, here you can see that how many test cases has run, no errors, no failures, so that it will move into the next stage. So this checking has been done in an automatic way. And once this is completed, finally, the artifacts would be ready. The signing in of the RPMs will happen. This is getting digitally signed by the following the Cisco CSDL process, so that customers should get to know that how the platform is being signed in and how the things are being taken care of. After this, once the signing in of the package is done, it is getting into publish into the internal release artifactory for triggering the nightly build deployment. So next level, it will get into the deployment in the integration test bed. Here you can see in this particular folder of the artifactory or the repository, it is being published. We will see in a few seconds that artifactory workplace where all these packages will be available. The nightly build deployment will take care of the entire show to be happened. So here you can see that 7.5.0 folder, the things have been kept, all the signed in RPM packages. Now, as a next step, we have completed this part. Now we will be coming over here in the integration testing to be happened. So here we will perform the sanity testing. We will be performing the CSDL analysis if it is needed. And all the things will be ready for the customer lab to send out. Now let's see how this is going to happen quickly. The beauty of this framework is that you are not going to run this pipeline as an individual process. One pipeline gets completed, another one gets triggered automatically. So here in this pipeline, we are going to run the sanity test. If you can consider the previous pipeline, the triggered nightly build deployment, this stage is going to kick off this pipeline. And as part of the process, it will first initialize the services. It will deploy the services. Then you can see over here that it is getting into the CXTA Docker container deployment, which is a test automation framework deployment. And everything is getting controlled through the pipeline. And test automation framework is getting linked with the services, with the device and the system under test. And one by one, the sanity test cases are being executed. Once this is being completed, the entire build will be pushed into the artifactory in a different location. If I could follow over here. So here you could see that QA verified folder, the build has been gone and it has got all the log files over there. And you can check it out, the log files. So this is a proof of testing towards the customer. Now, testing has been completed. The QA verification has been done. Build is present in the QA verified. What next? We should be now getting into deliver it into the customer premise. So once the second pipeline gets completed, the third will be kicked out automatically, and the third pipeline is going to take care of the execution of the entire show in an automatic fashion. So here you could see that build to send external artifactory. Here we have various products, but we will be choosing only the product which we have worked on, and we will be making it proceed. So what will happen at this point of time, it will start asking for the release, which release you would like to send over there. In a few minutes, you will be able to see here that how the releases are being getting selected. So that you can consider, here you can see it's waiting for the input requested. So release ID we have to give. And at this point of time, here you can see from the drag drop button, I'm just going to select 7.5.0 QA verified release, and it will start pulling up all the packages from my internal Artifactory, and it will try to push into over there. If I can just quickly walk you through that, how the exact process is going to work out. So here you can see that it's collating all the packages alongside with the test automation logs and details. And finally, it is going to push everything into the Cisco public cloud. So here is the Cisco public cloud, which has been shared with the customer with all the details. So this is how it is being getting transferred for the customer delivery. And at the end of the life cycle, entire show, one can be able to see that email delivery pipeline details, which will basically talks about what all bill has been sent and what is its status and how good it is. So you can see the total content which has been delivered to the customer side. When we talk about this particular multi-level pipeline, just pay attention that there is no manual intervention in the entire process. So how customer is getting integrated with our Cisco pipeline over here? So we have deployed the bill in the P3 stage with the external Artifactory deployment. And once that is being done, customer will receive a trigger to the customer side and they will pull it out in their P2, and their CI/CD platform is being integrated with our side. The entire P2, P1P will get into in an automatic fashion. So it's a zero touch delivery model where every day and night the build deployment can be done in a seamless way. What is the achievement out of this? So with this automated test execution and the delivery process, the first benefit is that it is not manually being controlled. Every time the things are being getting executed, if it is not up to the satisfaction, the build will not be delivered. So we have various checkpoints across which it can be checked. I have just populated one set of data where the 234 test cases were getting executed earlier with 32 man hours. Now with the automation is taking around 98.43% effort saving. And if you consider a scenario from code freeze till delivery, right now it takes approximately 3 hours, 3 hours, few minutes, which is significantly in progress comparing to the earlier manual delivery life cycle. So we propose that it increases the delivery efficiency of 94.12%. So CXSDM is a framework which can be utilized for any complex delivery service model, where you have to deliver multiple product in daily basis to the customer side. That's all for today from my side. Thanks for giving me the opportunity to speak over here. Thank you.